Good day, grade 12 learners. Welcome to today's geography lesson. My name is Nomthandazo Malembe. This lesson is brought to you by the Northern Cape Department of Education in collaboration with Palama Research and Development. So in today's topic, we're going to focus on the revision paper 2 under question 2. So before we start with our revision, we're going to go through the paper 2 topics as well as the weightings. So remember, your question paper is allocated with 150 marks and the duration of your paper is 3 hours, and then you will have your section A and your section B. Under your section A, you will have your settlement geography with 60 marks and you will have your economic geography with another 60 marks. Then you have your section B, which is your question 3, where there is a math work with 30 marks. So our focus today is on the question 2, which is your economic geography. So under your question 1, you will have your settlement A questions worth of 60 marks. And then under your question 2, you will have your economic geography with another 60 marks. That's a total of 120. And then under section B, which is your question 3, you will have your map work with 80 marks. Then the total will be 110. Then again, you have your question 2 with the short objective questions. Remember, they are 15 marks. That's your question 2.1 and your question 2.2. So together they will make a 15 marks, and these are the one-word questions. So here you are given 2 possible answers in the brackets. So you need to read the statement, then you choose one term that will make the whole statement to be true. So you've got your 2.1.1 and up to 2.1.3. So it's 1 minute per question, which means I'm going to give you 3 minutes to answer these questions. Remember, read the statement, then you write down the answer. If, for example, question 2.1.1, you are having 2 options, which is the primary or the secondary. If the correct answer is primary, then you write 2.1.1 primary. Then you proceed to 2.1.2, you read, and then you choose the correct answer. So after 3 minutes, you will then proceed to the next questions, and then after the questions for that figure are done, you will then be able to do the correction. So your 3 minutes starts now, and then after that, I'm going to display the following questions. Hoping that we are all done. So you now have your question 2.1.4 up to 2.1.7. So again, it's 1 minute per question, which means I'm now giving you 4 minutes. And then after 4 minutes, we will be able to do the corrections. Girls and boys, looking at our corrections. So 2.1.1, mining is an example of, so our key there was the mining, and then you know the example of the economic activity. Mining is an example of a primary. Remember, we have your mining, you have your fishing, your farming, and your forestry. So sometimes they can use any 4 of those examples. Then second question, the price of the minerals fluctuates in the mining industry due to that. We're looking at our option there between your foreign exchange and your foreign investment, because we are talking about the price of the minerals. If they fluctuate because of the foreign exchange, sometimes the rand is powerful, sometimes the rand is poor, so it's not in the stable condition. Then number 3, We're looking at the geothermal gradient or the unskilled labor. So is an example of a physical factor. Because of this physical factor, that makes the geothermal gradient to be the correct one. Then we're going to proceed to question 2.1.4 up to 2.1.7. So under your 2.1.4, platinum is an example of, you are given a renewable and a non-renewable. Remember, the platinum is a source that is non-renewable because it is made naturally. Then number 5, the platinum is mined in South Africa, in the Western Cape or Northern Cape. So the answer there, it is the Northwest. Then we're looking at 2.1.6. The platinum is used as a raw material in the production or generation of, is it a power or is it a jewelry? So the answer there is jewelry. Then number 7, the labor unrest. Remember, the labor unrest is the strike, or the labor availability in South Africa impact negatively on the production of platinum. Remember, if there are unrest issues, it means on that day there is no production. So therefore, the correct answer is labor unrest. Then we proceed to question figure 2.2. Figure 2.2 is a multiple choice question. Again, you are given a statement with option A up until D. Now you need to choose from the four options which one is correct. So we're going to display one question at a time up until we are done with question 2.2.8. So 1 minute at a time, and then we do the correction, then we proceed to the next question up until we reach the 8th question. So the tertiary sector is also preferred as the sector of. You are given the four options: your informal, your service, your health, and your transport. So 1 minute, you write down the answer. If it's A, write A. If it's B, you write B. If it's C, you write C. Then if it's D, you write D. And then after 1 minute, we do the correction. So there, we're looking at our option number B. Remember, the tertiary sector, we are saying it's where the services are rendered, or it's the provision of services. So it is also called a service sector. Then secondly, an example of the activity in the tertiary sector. So here you need to know the examples under the tertiary sector. You've got your A up until D. So again, I'm gonna give you that 1 minute, and then after 1 minute, we do the correction. Right, hoping that we are all done. We're looking there, an example of the tertiary sector, mining for gold. Remember, mining for gold, that is a primary. And then manufacturing wine. Remember, the products are manufactured in the secondary sector. So again, it is incorrect. Then we're looking at D, the canning beans. Remember, the canning of or food canning, it is also part of the secondary sector. Therefore, our option there is C, which is the foreign exchange, because we are rendering the service. Then number 3, we've got the 2-in-1 question. So the countries that are dominated by the tertiary sector reflect as, you need to choose two options. So for this one, I'm going to give you 2 minutes so that you can be able to make your combination. Remember, we are talking about the countries that are dominated by a tertiary sector. So after 2 minutes, we will be able to do the correction. We're looking there. We've got the Roman figure 1 with a high-skilled labor force. Remember we said it's the provision of services. And then B, we are looking at the poorly skilled labor force. So Roman figure 3, we are looking at the efficient transport system. And then Roman figure 4, the variety of mining activities. So looking at your Roman figure 2, which is poorly skilled labor, it is totally incorrect. And then we're looking at the variety of mining activity. Again, it is totally incorrect because we are talking about the countries that are dominated by the tertiary sector. So we're looking there, we are left with Roman figure 1 as well as Roman figure 3. So hence our answer is a C. So highly skilled labor force, remember that most of the people who are working at the tertiary sector, those are the skilled labor force. And then also the transport system is also an example of a tertiary sector. So our option C, which is Roman figure 1 and 3, are the correct one. Then we're looking at our question number 4. The contractual agreement. So here is our key, is the contractual agreement between countries relating to their trade relationship is known as, you have your option A and your option D. So I'm gonna give you 1 minute, and then after 1 minute you will be able to do the correction. So remember, we said the key is within. So looking at our option A, it says international. So it is wrong because international, it means overseas. And then B, we are looking at the regional. And C, we are looking at provincial, which means this could be a distraction. Is it a regional or is it a provincial? Because our exchange, it is within the country. But now looking at option C, remember we said we're talking about the trading, and within the country we said it's a domestic. If we don't want to say domestic, sometimes they can use the word local. So regional and provincial, they also become incorrect because of the domestic trade that is within. Then we're going to question 2.2.6. Your question 2.2.6, the type of a trade shown on the map is. So to give the clue, we have the imports and we have the exports. So what type of a trade is shown here? You have your option A up until option D. So again, 1 minute, and then after 1 minute we will be able to do the correction. So looking there at our option, we have the national, we have the regional, and we have the domestic. Remember, national, it is still within the country. The region as well as the domestic is within the country. So the option B is international. Why? Because there is an import, which means there are goods that are coming from other countries to our country. And they are exports, which means they are goods that we are sending out of the country. So therefore, international is the one that is most correct. Then we're looking at our question 2.1.7. The economic disadvantage of importing goods. So here you must have an understanding that importing goods, it means we are receiving goods from other countries. So what are the economic disadvantage for that? You've got your option A is up to option D. So you read and then you pick up one answer, and then after that we will be able to do the correction. So looking there at our option, we've got, we are looking for economic disadvantage, remember, in the importing of goods, meaning allowing goods to come into our country. So creation of a local employment, is that a disadvantage? No, because we are looking at more people who will be employed. Then number C, the goods becoming cheaper. So if goods are becoming cheaper, it means it's an advantage to us because we'll be spending less. And then option D, we are looking at growth of local industries. If local industries are growing, it means it's an advantage. So therefore, let us look at option B. Option B, it says production suffers locally, which means the local products, they suffer because of the importing of goods which are cheaper. So therefore, looking there, because we're supposed to give a disadvantage, option B is the most correct. Then we're coming to question 2.1.8. It's another two in one. So an advantage of South Africa having a favorable balance of trade. So remember, a favorable balance of trade, it means we are equal in terms of the export as well as the import. So what are the advantages in South Africa? So again, we have your Roman figure IA1, which is the foreign capital decreases, and we have the Roman figure 2, which jobs are created, and Roman figure 3, the retrenchment of workers, and Roman figure 4, stimulates the economic growth. Remember, we are looking for the advantage. So I'm going to give you 2 minutes for this one, and then after 2 minutes, we will be able to do the correction. So looking there at our option, we have our option D, which is your Roman figure 2 as well as your 4. Remember, to decrease in terms of the foreign capital, that is a disadvantage. And then the retrenchment of workers is also a disadvantage. So therefore, job being created is an advantage, and stimulates economic growth is another advantage. Hence, the option was D, which is your Roman figure 2 and your Roman figure 4. Then we want to proceed to our long question, which is figure 2.3. So your figure 2.3 is based on the extract. So this is the extract. So we're gonna go through the extract first, and then after we display the questions, and then after displaying the question, I'm gonna give you the opportunity to read the extract on your own, where else you know what are the questions. So the country's coal mining industry employs almost 92,000 people who earn some 29.6 billion. Some 70% of the local mined in South Africa is consumed domestically, with some 81% of electricity being generated from coal. At current rate of production, South Africa has reserved sufficient to satisfy its needs for more than a century. With a shallow and a high quality resources in the Witbank or Emalahleni, coal field being depleted, mining companies are required to find alternative and more cost-effective methods to extract the deeper or lower quality coal seams of the basin. So remember this year, in your South African products, so you coal is one of the products that will be examined this year. So hence our focus is more on the coal as well as on the beef. So let us look at, we also have the diagram. Beside the extract, we also have the diagram. We've got the key there, which is the coal mines. So in the map of South Africa, we've got four provinces that are being displayed there. And then we're looking at the coal production. So let us go through the questions. So I'm going to display the first three, and then after that, we're going to have the another three, because we've got six questions in total. So going through the first question, the first three questions, it says, according to the map, which province in South Africa has the most amount of the coal field? Remember, most, it means more or the bigger. Then secondly, according to the article, what is the main source of coal mined in South Africa? Then number three, with reference to the graph, in which year did South Africa produce the highest amount of coal? So you know the first three questions. So let us go through the diagram so that you can refresh on the questions that are based on the diagram, and then the questions that are based on the graph as well as on the map. And then I'm going to give you 5 minutes to go through the extract again on your own. And then after 5 minutes, you will then be able to proceed to the answering of the questions. Right, looking at our solutions. So your 1.3.1, you are supposed to give according to the map. which province in South Africa has the most of the coal field, you will see there that at Mpumalanga, being led by the key, so Mpumalanga is the most province that has the coal field. Then secondly, according to the article, you name the main use of the coal mine in South Africa. So the coal in South Africa is used to generate electricity or to produce electricity. We found that in the article. Then number three, we are looking at, with the reference to the graph, we are looking for the year in which South Africa produces the highest amount of coal. It was in 2014. Remember, coal is one of the non-renewable resources. So we're coming to question 1.3.4, whereby again, according to the infographic, the major challenge facing the coal mining in South Africa. So there we've got a more than a one. So it's either you went with the shallow and a high quality a resource in the Witbank or Emalahleni coal field being depicted, or you chose the one that says the mining companies are required to find alternative or more cost-effective methods to extract the deeper. Then we're looking at our question 1.3.5, whereby you are supposed to explain the negative impact that coal mining will have on the natural environment. So the natural environment, the air pollution is one of them, environment, and also the water pollution, which resources as well as the groundwater is also part of the environment, and the polluted water which will destroy our ecosystem is also part of the environment. And also we are looking at the marine biodiversity is affected, those animals that lives in water. So remember, we are looking at the natural environment. Then we're looking at our question 1.3.6, whereby you are supposed to discuss how the coal mining has a positive impact on the economy of South Africa. So you are looking for the three options. There we can say the coal mining industry, they contributed approximately 37 billion to the economy. Remember, we take that from the extract. And also the coal is contributing to the GDP. Remember, those companies, they are paying tax and their employees are also contributing towards the tax. And then also, if the taxes are paid, it means it's going to stimulate our economic growth and develop our South Africa as a country. Then we also at 1.3.6, so other options, we're looking at the coal mines that can be funded to develop the infrastructure. Remember, we're talking about the products that will be transported, it's either internationally or domestically. So obviously, there will be an improve in the infrastructure. And then we're also looking at the job creation that will be created, because those industries, they will be looking for employees. So obviously, if more people are employed, it means their quality of life will also be improved. Then we're also looking at the industries which will develop as the demand of the tools as well as the machinery. So those machines that are used in those coal mining industries will also have other industries that will be formulated. The ones that will be dealing with the tools and the ones that will be dealing with the machines. So it means more industries that will be formulated and more people will be employed also. Remember, the more the industries, the more the contributions that will be made towards the tax. So coal not only is used here in South Africa, which means we will be able to trade this coal into the other countries, which means we will be able to have the foreign exchange, or we will be doing the international trade. So any of the three. Then we proceed to figure 2.4. You are having a diagram there that is based on the the beef farming, and also we have the extract as well as the provinces where you can get this beef we are talking about. Remember, beef, it's also part of your question paper for this year, so you will write with it now up until your final paper. So to go through the extract, the beef industry is the second fastest growing commodity in agricultural sector, following the broiler sector. Approximately 80% of South African agricultural land is suitable for extensive grazing. The South African the gross value of beef production created increase from the 16 billion in 2010 or 11 to 37 billion in 2017 or 18. The overall increase in the past decade was due to the increased consumption of beef during the past years. So beef is produced throughout South Africa. The graph below shows the beef production per province during 2019 to 2020 production year. So there aside, we have the provinces with the percentage. So we're looking there, we're starting with the Western Cape with 5%, you've got your Eastern Cape with 8%, your Free State with 19%, and then your Gauteng with 17%, and KwaZulu-Natal with 9%, and Limpopo with 5%. Then we're looking at Mpumalanga with 21%, and the Northern Cape with 7%, and lastly, your Northwest with 9%. So let us go through the question. You're going to have your first three questions, and then we're going to display the next three questions again. So our first three questions, which province in South Africa produces the most beef during 2019 to 2020 production year? So the reason why we're going through the graph one by one. Then secondly, identify one physical factor favoring beef farming in South Africa mentioned in the article. So one physical factor that is favoring. Also, it will be the one that is mentioned in the article. Then number three, account for the increase in beef production. When the question says account, it means explain. So again, we're going to display the diagram, which is your pie chart, as well as your extract, so that you can be able to read on your own now that you are aware of the questions that have been asked, so that when you pick up the answers, you will then be able to write them down. So I'm going to give you this 5 minutes to go through the diagram, which is your pie chart, as well as your extract. And then after 5 minutes, you will then proceed to the questions. Hoping that we are all done. So our next question, 1.4.4, you suggest one way in which the South African government can assist the informal, which is your subsistence. So remember when we are still learning about the types of farming. So the subsistence, which is the cattle or the beef farmers, to increase the production. So we just need one way. Then question number 1.4.5, you discuss how beef production impacts positively. So we are looking at the beef production impacting positively on the economy of South Africa 2 times 2, meaning you give 2 responses. Then question 1.4.6, it says discuss the environmental factors that impact negatively. So environmental factors that impacted negatively on the beef production in South Africa. It's another 2 times 2, which means 2 responses. So for this one, I'm going to give you 10 minutes to work on these 3 questions, and then after 10 minutes, we will be able to do the corrections. With the hope that we are all done. So looking at our first question, our first 3, the province there, we are saying it's Mpumalanga. Remember Mpumalanga, they said it's 19%. So it was the one with the highest. Then secondly, to identify one physical factor that have a favored beef. Remember, we are supposed to take it from the article. So it says approximately 80% of South Africa's agricultural land is suitable for extensive grazing. So suitable land, that is a physical factor. Then number 3, to account for the increase in the beef production in terms of 2010 and 2011. So there, why there was an increase is because due to the increase in consumption. So there are so many people who were eating beef in that year, which means it has increased. Then we're looking at our question 1.4.4, whereby you are supposed to suggest one way in which the government can assist these informal beef farmers to increase the production. Right? We're looking at for these people to be able to have access to the loans and to be able to have some sort of refinement. And also, these people, they also need to know or to learn about the technical as well as the scientific methods that they can use in order to increase the beef production. And also, we're looking at for them to be able to do more research on the farming methods. Then, we're looking at our question 1.4.5, whereby we're supposed to discuss how the beef production impact positively on the economy of South Africa. So obviously in those beef industries, because they are able to export their product, it means they will be able to contribute towards the GDP. As they are doing the foreign exchange or they are receiving the foreign income, it will also help to stimulate our economy. And also looking at other variety of beef products that will be sold within as well as internationally. Also, there will be people who will be working in this industry, which means there will be employment that will be created. And also, we're looking at the source of raw material that will be used in the industries. Remember, in terms of the packaging. And also, we're looking at other food that will be produced through the beef, which means there will be a variety of what we are exporting to other countries as well as domestically. Then we're looking at our question 1.4.6, whereby you are supposed to discuss the environmental factors that impact negatively on the beef production in South Africa. Remember, we're looking at the environmental factors. So obviously, if there are drought conditions, it means there is less or no rainfall at all, which means during that time, the cattle won't have water to drink, which means they will be limited. And also, we're looking at the lack of the equipment, especially amongst the small-scale farmers. So even we're talking about the tractors that they can use if they don't have, it also limits them. Then we're also looking at the diseases that could lead into these cattle dying. Remember, the vaccine, they are expensive. So obviously, if these farmers, they won't be able to afford the vaccines. It means that their cattle are going to die. Then we're looking at the insufficient or the decline of the grazing land. Remember, if there is a shortage of grazing land, it means these cattle won't be fed enough, which means they will be leading into death or being attacked by different diseases because they are not eating healthy. Then we're looking at figure 1.5. Remember your figure 1.5. Also, the Saldanha Bay is the IDZ that will be questioned this year. So you have an extract and then you've got the picture there with the harbor and the Atlantic Ocean. So to go through the extract, the Saldanha Bay Municipality has resolved to stimulate a sustainable local economic development and employment opportunity within the municipal area. The aim is to encourage international competitiveness and sustainable economic growth through the strategic investment in export manufacturing industries in the Saldanha Bay municipal area. So the Saldanha Bay IDZ is purpose-built industry, the industrial estate linked to an international port, which is a harbor, which has been specifically designated for new investment by export-oriented industries and related services. So let us go through the questions. You have your question 1.5.1 up until 1.5.5. So the first question, you need to state one key objective of industrial development zone. So again, by reading the extract, you're going to have those objectives. And then you state one factor that is evident in the image that favor the development of Saldanha Bay. And then question number three, what economic impact is the Saldanha Bay IDZ expected to have on the local communities as mentioned in the article? So another reason why you should read the article. Then number four, you discuss the impact that the development of Saldanha Bay IDZ will have on the infrastructure in the area. So the focus is on the infrastructure. Then number five, you explain how Saldanha Bay IDZ can overcome some of the challenges it is facing. So 2 times 2, which means you need 2 options. So again, I'm going to give you another opportunity to look at that picture as there is an answer that is based on the picture, and also to reread the extract on your own. So I will give you 5 minutes to go through the picture as well as the extract, and then after that I'm going to display the questions again. So with the hope that we are all done reading the extract and we have seen the picture, so we're going to display the questions. I'm going to give you 10 minutes to work on these 5 questions, and then after 10 minutes you will be able to do the corrections. Hoping that we are all done. So looking at our first question, to state one key objective of the industrial development zone, which is your IDZ in South Africa. While amongst those key objectives, we are looking at to create the new jobs and also to attract the foreign investors. And we are looking at to encourage or to increase the level of a foreign direct investment in the economy. And we are looking at to encourage to promote the international competitiveness in the country's manufacturing sector. So Amy, you get 2 marks. Then we're looking at your question 1.5.2, whereby you are supposed to state one factor that is evident in the image that favored the development of the Saldanha IDZ. We have seen there in the image that it has a harbor. Then number three, what economic impact the Saldanha Bay IDZ expected to have on the local communities, as mentioned in the article. So there it says it stimulates the sustainable local development as well as the employment opportunities. So that is the 2 marks. Then looking at your question 1.5.4, we're looking to discuss the impact that the development of Saldanha Bay IDZ will have on the infrastructure of the area. Infrastructure, we're talking about the roads, we're talking about your harbors, we're talking about your airport, we're talking about your railway. So therefore, the road networks in Saldanha Bay will be extended. Remember, we're talking about the impact of the development of the Saldanha Bay on the infrastructure. So therefore, the harbor facilities also will be improved or will be extended. And also we're looking at the railway networks that will be upgraded. And we're looking at development of more facilities and also your electricity as well as the water infrastructure will also be improved. Then question 1.5.5, we're looking there to explain how the Saldanha Bay IDZ can overcome some of the challenges it is facing. So remember, one of the challenges in Saldanha Bay is that there are no skilled workers. So most of the skilled workers, they migrate to Cape Town because it is closer to Cape Town and there are more opportunities in Cape Town, as well as the standard of living is more improved in Cape Town. So it's one of the challenges. So there we are looking at the low levels of skilled labor can be solved by providing more training programs to upskill their workers. And also we're looking at the skilled labor that tend to move to Cape Town. We've already mentioned that. So if they can provide the incentives so that those skilled workers cannot move to Cape Town if they have incentives. And also we're looking at the harbor that needs to be advanced in terms of the container. And also we're looking at to invest in the source of energy. Remember, one of the crises in the Saldanha Bay is the shortage of electricity. So if they can invest in other forms of electricity, it could also be it could also be that they have overcome their challenges. Then we're looking at summarizing what we have learned today. So we have learned about the economic sector and we have learned about the coal mining. Remember, this is our product for this year. And we have learned about the beef production. Also, it will be exempt this year. Then we're looking at the Saldanha IDZ. Also, it's part of our question paper this year, the Saldanha IDZ. And then we're looking at our preview for our next lesson. So the preview for our next lesson, we're going to still be focusing on paper 2, a revision. We'll be doing our question 3. Remember, our question 3 is the map work. So we will be focusing on the map work. So we have come to an end of our lesson today. Hopefully you have learned as much as possible, but most of all, I hope you have enjoyed the lesson. Thank you and stay tuned for the next one.